Among the misty Blue Ridge Mountains near the town of Asheville, North Carolina, where visitors flock in droves every autumn to witness one of the most visually stunning displays of nature, the leaves are changing, illuminating this region and bringing it brilliantly to life. Also in these parts is a course carved out of a hillside unlike anything else in action sports. It's where the top BMX riders in the world will compete in the biggest dirt competition of the year. This is Dreamline. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series. Everybody, Sal Masekela here, your host of the Red Bull Signature Series, and allow me to welcome you to the outskirts of Asheville, North Carolina, and the Oscar Blues Ranch. This is the home to this year's biggest BMX competition, Dreamline. Now, we're about to witness the riders from seven different nations navigating a course with a total of 10 jumps, most of these two stories in height, and the largest being a 22-foot jump over a 36-foot gap. It's gonna send these riders to the moon. Now remember, these are BMX bikes. There's no suspension, and they're gonna reach speeds of nearly 35 miles an hour. They'll be about 40 feet in the air, and of course, they'll be trying to perform the most progressive tricks that they can. The final session is underway. What's up, guys?
Sal, we're in store for a great day. Here's the format. Best one run score counts. It's scored out of 100, and no score if the rider does not complete a full run. Kenan, what are the judges looking for?
Judges are going to be looking for style, how the riders attack this course, the amplitude, flow, variety, and trick difficulty. Basically, you should do a trick on every single jump, and that's going to bump you up to the top of the podium.
All right, before we get rolling, let's check in with the fourth member of our broadcast team down on the track. Here is Tina Dixon.
Well, guys, right after practice, we received quite a bit of rain, and the course builders went straight to work, but they did a great job of protecting these jumps, protecting the course, and once the sun came out, it just baked this North Carolina dirt. But that's the reason that this venue was chosen, is this mountain is covered in that perfect buildable material that you need for this type of event, and what a course they built. These last three jumps are massive, almost double the height in what you would see in a normal BMX event, similar to what you would see in freestyle motocross, and with the dirt stain intact, the rain not an issue, it's go time.
All right, thank you, Tina. Before we have go time, let's take a look at this course up close and personal with the man who conceived Red Bull Dreamline, Anthony Napolitan.
Hey, what's up? My name's Anthony Napolitan. We're here at Red Bull Dreamline, and this is your GoPro course preview. Take a couple pedals up top. Get some speed firm, little manual, little baby tabletop through the next berm, up into the first jump, berm, long and low. We got two options going left today. Up over the next jump, kind of a shifty right-handed hit, where I'm picking up a lot more speed to hit this big booter. Heading over the big roller to kind of control my speed. Going into the berm section that leads into the sharp fin. Kind of gonna go up and over. Big booter, lofty jump. Big left hand hip. Setting up for a nice backy. Woo! Berm at the end. Yeah. Woo! That was awesome.
Big thanks to Anthony for bringing us that first-hand look at this incredible course. This is Mike Clark out of Southern California, set to drop in his run. Now, this guy is so creative, he almost does maybe a little too much sometimes, Kenan, and he pays the price.
Yeah, he's not afraid to go big or go down. I mean, that's the truth right there. That's why they call him Hucker. Lots of fun to ride with. This guy's really good on a bike. He's very unique in the way he rides it. He comes up with different tricks that are unto himself. Just the style on that no-footed can-can there, that's a Hucker no-footed can-can into that nice tuck no-hander. But look at how stretched Hucker gets.
So Mike Clark halfway through this run. Now he's approaching the big three features that wrap the thing up.
Yeah, this is where I get nervous watching him.
And one more for Mike Clark. Winds
yes!
it up.
All right. Good run from Mike.
So a full pole for Mike Clark out of Southern California, Kenan. This was a thing of beauty.
Yeah, it definitely was. You know, it's an old school Superman, but he takes it to a completely another level by the amount of stretch he puts on it. And again, with his tuck, no-handed backflip. Just throws the hands off there. He doesn't actually get the bars in that lap. And I love the style of his inverted 360, throwing that back leg off to balance himself.
And the score for Mike Clark on run number one, it's an 80.2, so a strong run for Clark. This is Pat Casey. He is the defending champion here at Dreamline. What can he pull off here? A lot of pressure, Ken. As you pointed out before, every year they change this course, and this thing is an absolute behemoth.
You know, he's a young rider. He's got a lot of skills. Started BMX racing years ago. He actually handles this pressure well for such a young rider. And I love also the way that he executes his tricks as he makes his way down. Little style here. And we're going to get really fast coming into this next set of dubs. Scrubbing some speed, slowing himself down. Very important. It's almost, that's where the technique comes in, knowing how to read this course. Big 360 tail whip, linking things together, a tail whip to no-hander, and what's it gonna be on the last hit? A huge decade, big trick for the end.
So the 20-year-old from Yorba Linda, California, with a very strong run here just outside of Asheville, North Carolina.
Loved it up top when he did that toboggan 360, but it was at the bottom where he started threading together some tricks. And here's two tricks in one air. That's a 360 and a tail whip. So it's a 360 tail whip, and he follows that up with a tail whip to no-hander. But here's where I really love this trick. It's one of a personal favorite. It's a decade air. He floats off the pedals and goes around the head tube. Had he pushed a little too hard, he would have been on the ground. He would have crashed that.
Strong score for Pat Casey, the young man out of Yorba Linda, California, the defending champion here at Dreamline. This is 20-year-old David Godziak out of Poland looking for a big score here at Dreamline.
He's great on the dirt, also a fantastic park rider. Riding for a while now. Look at this, going for the back end there on that 360, grabbing the seat. Yes, look at this. That was some sick style. That's a no-footed can-can, but he throws the back end out in front of him. It's really amazing. It's like a whip no-footer.
The final three for Godziak.
Whoa, straight back flip. Godziak with a solid run. Don't know if it's enough to get to the top of the podium, but it definitely had moments of brilliance in it. And I really love what he did, putting his own stamp on some of those tricks. Case in point here, it's an Indian air, but when he grabs the seat, he pushes the bike away from him, and that really accentuates the trick, and he makes it his own. And then finally, he does a straight backflip, looking for possibly a no-hander, but is able to do a little bit more with that bar spin to tabletop. And then the final jump is a straight 360. Again, these were, in my opinion, missed opportunities.
79.2 from the young man out of Poland, David Godziak. Australian Kyle Baldock, mainstay on the Dew Tour, sitting to drop in now on run number two. And you get the feeling that Baldock may be holding something back for the very final run. Something special, maybe?
You know, it's possible, Todd, but most likely not. Baldock is just out there, man. You see a double tail whip to an opposite side tail whip just in the course of two jumps. Now he's down here in the middle section, and he does an off-axis 720. Very risky move to do in the middle of this course. You can hear the brakes squeaking, checking some speed. Beautiful tail whip over the shark fin. Lots happening. I don't think he's holding back. In fact, what do we got here for the final jump? Big tail whip backflip to finish things off.
Great run by the Aussie Kyle Baldock.
Yeah, I understand, bro. At any given moment, it could be total disaster here at Dreamline, but not today. Double tail whip at the top, but watch the opposite direction he now kicks that back end. It's like being ambidextrous. He can write with both hands, he can spin both directions. Very technical trick. And this is a burly yet technical trick. It's an off-axis 720. And then coming into the home stretch, we had an amazing tail whip backflip to finish things off. Good job.
And the score for Kyle Baldock of Australia is an 83.4. Mike Clark set to drop in the man they call Hucker. Set to drop in on a beautiful course here on a beautiful day just outside of Asheville, North Carolina.
Mike's starting to get into the flow of his run. Nice 360 off those top sections. Opposite there with a nice tabletop. Both directions spinning, very important. The judge is gonna notice that, know the degree of difficulty. Very high on those tricks. Yeah, no-footed can-can to no-footer on the way back in. Scrubbing some speed as we get into this shark fin. Hucker style 360. Coming towards the last hits, gotta be big. And it's an opposite three, and
oh,
he goes down. Oh man, he gets the whiplash.
Mike Clark with a big crash at the end of his run, gets up, able to walk away. The fans appreciating the effort that Hucker just put in here at Dreamline.
And again, this is a lot of risk for a technical trick, and he's turning a tech trick like an opposite 360 into something burly because he's doing it off such a massive jump, but he clips that front wheel. Watch as he spins. Watch the back of his head. That's why they're wearing the helmets, folks. Very important. Again, another look, an over-rotate, but he clips the front wheel, spins around back. Oh, man, I'm glad to see him get on up, but he did say ouch.
So Mike Clark will look to the next run, walks away safely, and we'll look for Hucker to put up a bigger score on his next effort. This is James Foster set to drop in here on run number two.
One of my favorite new school riders, Foster, does some very big tricks. You know, he's on tour with Nitro Circus, double front flips. I mean, you are seeing some very progressive moves out of him. And Dreamline is the type of course that you can get progressive on. How about that super stretch suicide no-hander? He actually dipped down that front wheel. Lots of control.
And this is just the appetizer of what's yet to come. James Foster making his way past the judges' tower. Now he comes on to the big features at the end of the course.
Yeah, a couple of bar spins thrown while he's upside down. Straight air over this, getting some speed for the final hit. He's gonna clean it up with a tail whip backflip. Yeah, sure, lots of fun. Let's go back up and see how much fun he had. A bar spin to turn down right there at the top. Two tricks in one air, and then here, bar spin, and an X up. That's a lot going on while you're upside down, Todd. You know, you've got to be precise, and it's all done by feel. You're not really seeing those bars spin. And then finally, he just threaded it right into that backflip tail whip, finds it, and gets home safely to Mother Earth.
And a score coming down for James Foster. It's an 82 as he heads back to the top of the course here at Dreamline. Ryan Nyquist set to drop in. This will be his third run here on the Dreamline course, and you got to wonder, what's going through the mind of 35-year-old Ryan Nyquist, and what's his motivation to continue to bring his body out here and take a beating?
You know, I've never met a more serious competitor. I mean, Ryan's a lot of fun. He jokes around a lot. He has a great time. But he's a rider that definitely pushes through certain circumstances, and he is extremely competitive. And I think that's actually a good thing. We are in a competition after all.
So Nyquist on course, what's he got? And he's already carrying a ton of speed.
Yeah, you know, and he's weaving his way through those transfers there with a few truck drivers thrown in. Second one actually had two bar spins in it. Nice one-footed tabletop 360. You know, Ryan exemplifies dialed. He's been doing this for many years. How about it? I feel like I might have jinxed him as he over-rotates that bar spin backflip. Gosh, that could hurt so bad.
But nobody can turn a bad situation into a decent landing like Nyquist. Let's look at this one more time.
Yeah, you know, he just pulls a little too hard as he misses the landing there a little bit with the front wheel. The backflip is all about getting the right amount of flip. So he bar spins, but watch, he tugs it a little bit with the arms and he's got too much rotation and he manuals out. That's a wheelie, for those of you who are new to BMX, and it spills him onto his tookish.
We're down to the finals. Kyle Baldock leads the way with an 83.4. Then it's Pat Casey, the defending champion, and James Foster, the top three. The 23-year-old Dennis Anderson out of La Mesa, California. Kenan, there's certain guys that just know how to shine in competition, and this is one of them.
Whether it's street, true street, or park, this guy definitely knows how to ride his bike, and he has complete mastery over it. And now he's on the biggest dirt course out there. Nice no-hander, old school, getting a little nosedive, Todd.
Anderson looking smooth, fresh off a Dew Cup victory in the Dew Tour this year. And Kenan, he looks so at home on these big dirt jumps.
You see right there, a very interesting point. He drops his foot to scrub speed. He's one of the few riders who's not using brakes today. Todd, it's insane when you think about the speeds these guys are generating. Nice, no-handed 360 into the second jump. Looks like he's just gonna boost it once he got on the final jump. No way, huge 360 tail whip. Anderson not afraid to go big, but again, gotta stress the fact, this guy's not riding with brakes. You'd never catch me doing that in my day, but these guys, some of them like to take the brakes off. Here's that cannonball. It's a double grab, no footer, throwing the bike out in front of you. Nice turn down, utilizing that shark fin berm. But it's here. Watch the handlebars. He's going to throw them into his lap. He locks them in. That enables him to take his hands off while rotating 360 degrees. And then finally, who doesn't love a huge 360 tail whip? I can see that trick all day. And when Anderson does them, they're pretty lofty.
So the 23-year-old from La Mesa, California, ups the ante. His score an 84.8, and he goes into first place. We have competitors from around the globe here today, including our next rider to drop all the way from Australia. This is Kyle Baldock.
I love the Aussies, man. They've been coming over here for many years and showing their skills. These guys know what it takes to really make the crowd scream. Kyle came over here a few years ago, didn't do too well in competition, came back the following year and slayed it. One of my favorite riders to watch as he moves his way through this course. How about it? Off access. Nice move there. Getting into some speed here. What? There was so much going on there. 360 tail whip, and then he gets himself a decade out. It's like a tail whip to tail whip out. This is an amazing rider. Coming down to the big sets.
Launches it.
Todd, 360 backflip. Baldock is going off on these massive jumps here at Dreamline. And stomps it.
Very clean for the Aussie, Kyle Baldock, 23 years of age, out of Queensland Gold Coast. We may have a new leader. That was an impressive run.
Definitely getting inverted with this off-axis 720. Not a lot of guys can do that trick and have it so dialed on such big jumps. Baldock, not a problem. What I really love is the loft factor on this final jump, the tail whip backflip. He catches the pedal so high up there, he could potentially squeeze a bar spin in on the way back to Earth. Really fantastic job from an amazing rider.
And the score for Baldock of Australia is an 85.2, so Baldock is the new leader here at Dreamline. Well, next up is Mike Clark, and you can see he's got a little bit of dirt on his shoulder there. Let's take a look back at what happened. This was earlier on one of the early runs, the 27-year-old out of Huntington Beach, California. Watch this.
He's going for an opposite 360. You can see he just doesn't have the bike lined up right, and he clips that front wheel, and he just has to take a slide down that massive landing. His name is Hucker. It's just been a bad day for him. Once again, front wheel, bam! Not a good way to go down on a 360 or on a set of doubles. Definitely don't want to hang up your front wheel. It's okay, Hucker's safe. We're gonna see what he can do in this next run.
So Mike Clark up, dusting himself off, and here he goes on his next voyage down to this amazing course here at Dreamline.
Hucker getting set up for the first of some big moves here. It's where we get the transfers. Opposite 360, and then goes his normal direction with an X up one-handed three into a tuck no-hander.
Remember the mark to beat right now put up by Kyle Baldock's an 85.2.
And when he's not out here riding, you're gonna see him out in the woods looking for snakes, a man after my own heart. Look out, man, such style on that 360. Almost inverted, Todd. And here's the last huge jump. Gets it, no problem. Definitely a better run than we've seen from him all day long. He's not adding to that new dirt-colored t-shirt that he's wearing right now. But Hucker, man, incredible. Mike Clark, watch the back leg. He throws it off. Actually, that helps him counterbalance that rotation since he's so off-axis. And the 360 tail whip, done perfectly, lands really high on the landing. That's the safest spot to land. Keep your eye on the feet. They find the pedals, lands really high. Had there been another jump after this one, he would have kept his rhythm going.
And Mike Clark checks in with an 83.4, so a clean run from top to bottom for Mike Clark, and it moves him into third place. Pat Casey, 20 years of age, out of Yorba Linda, California. He is the defending champion. And as you look at this course, Kenan, they have certainly upped the ante on the amplitude of these jumps.
Every year it's a new course. They definitely make them bigger. Progression is key in the sport of dirt jumping and BMX in general. And Casey is definitely one of those riders who likes to progress. I love the style we're seeing from him. Started riding at 5 years old. He was a BMX racer, and that definitely helps you with the comfort on dirt. No way, huge 360, kicking the legs off in the can-can section. And you see he's scrubbing some speed there. Also riding brakeless here. That is insane. Yeah, double tail whip 360 we've seen. That's the first one we've seen today. And how about a double tail whip out of that, linking these kicks together. This may be our new leader.
All kinds of speed from the defending champion as Pat Casey comes through. The judges talked about they wanted variety and they wanted uniqueness over consistency. And I think Casey gave it to them.
They got a little bit of everything. How about a double tail whip 360 followed by a double tail whip over that huge second set. But then finally, if you blink, you'll miss it. It's a truck driver or bar spin 360 to 360 tail whip. Watch the handlebars. It happens so fast, then he has to kick the back end of the bike around while he's rotating 360 degrees. He pulls it off, he's in a tank top. This guy's not afraid to get dirty.
And the score coming down for Pat Casey, it's strong. It puts him into second place. He's now standing by with Tina.
And Pat Casey, the defending champion, just looking so smooth, especially on those last three jumps. Walk us through that.
Thanks, yeah. Last three jumps, I did three double whip, then double whip, which I meant to do double whip tuck, and then last one truck to whip. But I don't know, jumps just feel really good, and it's out here having a good time riding.
Yeah, what's the attitude for you coming in as the defending champion?
I don't know, really. I mean, this whole event is just pretty chill, so you just come out here and just ride with your friends. And really, I think the whole thing behind it is just it's a session that everyone's just pumping each other up, so that's what makes everyone go off.
Have some fun today.
Thank you, Tina. As we take a look at the current standings, Kyle Baldock leads the way here in the final with an 85.2. Then it's the defending champion, Pat Casey, and Dennis Anderson currently sitting in third. We're in the finals of one of the premier events in Dirt BMX, and definitely the biggest course we've seen all year. Let's take a look at some of the speeds, heights, and the biometrics these riders experience on a course of this magnitude in the test drive. Starlatively tame, but it quickly escalates. Speeds in excess of 20 miles an hour. At that time, he gets the air meter over 11 feet. thanks to Mike Clark for sharing what he has experienced as he goes down this course in the test drive. Absolute legend set to drop in. This is 35-year-old Ryan Nyquist out of Santa Cruz, California. Four-time X Games gold medalist, countless Duke Cups, and now he is on course here in North Carolina.
He made his first appearance on the circuit in 1996 during a park competition. Most people didn't realize that he was such an amazing dirt jumper, and here, taking a transfer with a little bar spin thrown in, and that's what he was known for, those bar spins. He's just so proficient at that, but he's having a hard time here. Hanging up, that's definitely detrimental to keeping your speed, but Ryan able to bounce back.
This guy can adapt to almost anything. Multifaceted Ryan Nyquist halfway through the course.
Yes, 270 with a bar spin thrown in. 360, now that's just a normal 360. Guaranteed he wants to do a little bit more on it. And the same thing with this backflip. But you know, you hear that scream Nyquist throwing out. What a ride those last three jumps are. You are mocking when you're hitting those.
85.2 is the mark to beat. Did he do enough?
Well, he definitely had a lot of tricks, definitely with this suicide no-hander to late truck driver 360, and the only rider we've seen spin off the shark spin. And he actually threw the bars as well, 270 truck driver and a backflip one-handed X-up. But here, another trick no one else has done, he's actually doing a 360 over this hip. So we'll see what the judges say about it.
And there is your new leader. Ryan Nyquist moves into first place with a score of 89.6. So the foreign influence continues here at Dreamline. From Poland, 20-year-old David Godziek set to drop in on his run, carrying a lot of speed into this first corner.
He's got a very talented bike riding family. His brother Simon, actually one of the competitors at this year's Rampage event, which is an amazing mountain bike event. And look at Godziek getting involved. Look, oh no! So insane. Glad
Thumbs
to see him
up.
Yeah, glad to see him get back up. I mean, these guys are really going for it here. He gets an opposite tail whip, lands, and then goes for a Superman seat grab to late tail whip, but unfortunately just has to throw the bike away. And that's actually the way you want to get out of that trick. Get the bike as far away from you as possible so you can tuck and roll.
And how about Godziek making his way back to the top of the course? He will go for his next run. That was impressive. 33-year-old Chris Doyle out of the fighting town of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, still on the circuit, still with plenty of skills.
Yes, another veteran here, him and Nyquist, the old dogs. But you know what? I love watching Doyle ride. And this is the type of course that really suits his style. Very flowy rider. You may not see some of the backflips out of him, but you're going to see some very technical tricks and then tricks performed like that Superman, fully extended, no-footed can-can. This guy is awesome.
Chris Doyle, a mainstay on the Dew Tour, looking very smooth right now. The question is he doing enough to take down Nyquist in that 89.6?
You know, it's going to be tough. You know, the judges do really appreciate his style as he moves into this final rhythm section, big 360. Oh, yeah, he spins the hip as well. So that's another rider doing it in a clicked turn down 360.
Great run for Chris Doyle at 33 years of age, still able to come down a course like Dreamline and throw down a run like that.
So to you just joining us, to you newbies to BMX, I have to stress, style, so important, and this rider is filled with it. He doesn't necessarily go upside down, but when he does do his tricks, they're executed nicely. A straight 360 there, and he 360s this final set with that clicked turn down. Doyle, very impressive run.
So Chris Doyle moves into second place with a very impressive 85.8. Next up, it'll be 27-year-old Mike Clark out of Huntington Beach, California, a three-time Nora Cup Dirt Rider of the Year. And he's got the damage on that left shoulder to show it. He has been out here putting in some serious work.
I really love watching him ride. He does little things like that nose wheelie through the camel humps there that just... it's its own brand of riding from Hucker. Like we saw in the first run, opposite 360, followed by a regular 360, and we get a little motor whip. I love when we jump on board with the GoPro view.
Mark to beat, 89.6, put up by Ryan Nyquist.
And already this is different from his first run, going with that just kind of goofing around with a no-handed seat, excuse me, a no-footed seat grab, getting into the end here. Big flatty tabletop. This is where he had trouble on the last jump. Oh, and it's not going to work again. The opposite 360 is the bane of his existence today as he picks up yet a little bit more of that Asheville topsoil. Again, what happened here, it's an opposite 360. They're very difficult to judge the rotation on them. You have to almost be a little bit more gentle, Todd, when you pull off, because the slightest miscalculation will do this. It causes him to over-rotate. But him being a professional, he knows when to hit the eject button, and instead of getting tangled in that bike, just slides down on that palm.
Mike looks to be okay, but his day might be done as we take a look at our current standings. It's Ryan Nyquist on top, followed by Chris Doyle, Kyle Baldock, Pat Casey, and Dennis Enerson. That is James Foster, 28 years of age, out of Redlands, California, set to drop in on his next run here on this spectacular course. Remember, Ryan Nyquist is your current leader with an 89.6.
This is definitely another rider. He's got his own style, and he can do the technical tricks and the big burly ones as well. You'll find him on tour with the Nitro Circus Lunatics doing some incredible big air moves. How about a seat grab Indian air? Just railing the berm. Yeah, and two different no-handers in one air. You had a tuck and a suicide.
So Foster with a great run so far. Now he comes up to the big three.
There's the first one, and it's a X up. Wow, I don't know what was going on. It looked like an X up backflip to bar spin and a double tail up over the second. Holy, this is an incredible run from Foster. Todd, this may be taking over the lead here. Lots happening.
I cannot believe I pulled that run.
Neither can I. James, looking back at what he did. It is a bar spin to bar spin, triple bar spin. It all happened so fast, I couldn't see it the first time round. And this, the double tail whip, catches no problem. These are three massive tricks he is threading together right now. What was the final one? A bar spin to tail whip backflip. So much happened that just shouldn't be possible, but Foster defies possibilities.
86.8 for James Foster. That will move him into second place.
Wow, that's incredible. Ryan holding on to the lead.
So back to the top we go. Australian Kyle Baldock, the 23-year-old who had a great pull in his prior run.
Yeah, this guy charges, man. He's just got such a confidence on his bike, and that's what you love to see, whether you're a judge or a spectator, just a guy that can completely manhandle it. Right now, not doing much in the way of tricks, seems to be wanting to flow this course this time around, which could mean he's gonna do something just ridiculous at the end. Oh, well, there you have it. How about a backflip tail whip in the middle of your run?
Kyle Baldock is no stranger to high-pressure situations and competition, and now he's got the big three to finish this run up.
No way, and he just squeaks that around with that bar spin and tail whip backflip. Sticking to business on his second set. Oh, wow, such a big run, but in my opinion, you know, he had some big tricks, but when you're looking at Foster's run and you look at Nyquist's run, way more tricks on more of the course. He kind of took his time up top. It was here when he really started, and that was with that tail whip backflip. It was thrown in the middle of his run, but even still, with the level of competition we're seeing, you really got to pull things out immediately if you want to get on that podium. There was a bar spin to tail whip backflip, and here is a straight tail whip backflip. So impressive.
So the score for Kyle Baldock of Australia is an 85.2. That will put him in the top five, currently in fourth place. Ryan Nyquist leads the way, remember, with an 89.6, as Paul Langlands, the Kiwi, out of New Zealand, dropping in at 25 years of age.
Yeah, the Kiwis got their own style down there in the South Pacific. These guys really go big. You can see Paul getting a tire grab there. Lots of style from this Metal Militia rider. Love the seat grab Indian air. Getting himself railed through that berm. Nice opposite 360s. He scrubs some speed here on that little roller. No way, he's going off course, and he gets it back. How does he do that? I thought he would be in the middle of the field. And that is a throwback to a Corey Anastasio Superman seat grab, one of the best dirt riders to ever touch a BMX bike. Paul doing a great job at the end there. I'm more excited about how he recovered from this tail whip backflip. Watch where he lands. Way to the right of that landing and shoots him off to the left, but he somehow gets his radar back on. And watch this, he actually lands on the side of the landing. He missed the total top. So sick. And he puts it together with a completely extended Superman seat grab.
So Langland's out of New Zealand with maybe the best save of the day. His score comes in with an 84.6. Next rider, Dennis Anderson, trying to improve his current position of sixth place, and an 84.8 currently to Ryan Nyquist, looking on, and Anderson is on course.
Manualing through the top here, little things like this just show his skill. And I have to point out the fact he is riding with no brakes. That's another level of skill as he makes that no-handed transfer. Oh, and he hangs up a little bit, and that throws off the rhythm. You can see where he didn't quite get enough speed for that second jump. Superman C-Crab looking for the extension on that, scrubbing the speed over this roller as we head down to the fastest part of the course.
So Anderson really starting to pick up speed, the final three big features.
Looking like he's in a little bit of trouble this run, though. Definitely not one of the stronger runs that I've seen Anderson pull out.
So Dennis rides over to where the crowds are. Look at this one more time. This is very similar to his last run. Will the judges respond?
Yeah, you know what? The judges definitely want to see them pull either a safety run, as we like to call it, nailing all your tricks. And that way you can go and do something more in the second run if you choose to. Here, he didn't really have that. There were a few missed opportunities. Can't really blame him though, because these are tremendous dirt jumps.
So Dennis Anderson checks in with an 84.8. That's exactly what he had on the prior run, so he will remain in sixth place for the time being. Next man to drop in is the 2013 Red Bull Dreamline champion, Pat Casey. Now he's currently in fifth with an 85 even. Having a little chat with current leader Ryan Nyquist there, and now it's Pat Casey on course.
Tuck no-hander, and you got to watch how these guys land. Look at that, bar spin to toboggan. So important where they land. There's no suspension, as Sal said at the top of the show, on these bikes. So if you make one wrong move, you are going to be scrubbing too much speed. And I think that's what he was doing right here as he moves into the bottom half, going off this shark fin. And we got a tail whip off it, downside tail whip. Yeah, tail whip to Tuck no-hander. What's gonna be in the last one? Oh man, that was an incredible run. A tail whip catch, tail whip 360.
So the defending champion looks awfully good on this run. Had a little problem at the very end, but this is strong.
Oh yeah, downside tail whip off that shark fin, sets himself up for the three biggest jumps on the course. But this is an amazing feat. Tail whip, catches it, and throws the whip again, all in a 360. Lots happening. It's like a blender.
So Pat Casey was currently sitting on an 85, and his score comes in as an 87.2. So he's now in second place behind Ryan Nyquist. He's now standing by with Tina.
Pat, how difficult is that last trick that you just pulled?
I don't really think it's too bad because the jump's so big, but yeah, that one was a little harder, and I barely slipped the pedal, and my foot kind of hurts right now, but I'm okay.
Going back for more?
Yeah, for sure. I'm pretty sure we got like a few more runs, so definitely.
Looking forward to it.
Now, while we were away, our current leader, Ryan Nyquist, already in a secure lead, had another solid run, but did not improve his score of 89.6.
No, Ryan's sticking to business here. The thing is with Ryan, his business is serious. Not a lot of riders can chalk so many tricks into the course, and that's why he's doing so well. Had a little bit of a hi-ya on that landing. He hung up a little bit, but again, with this 270 off the shark fin into the final rhythm section, Ryan was definitely performing masterfully.
And a look at the judges working diligently on this, the biggest BMX dirt comp of the year. Riders coming from around the globe here to compete, like this next competitor. This is 20-year-old David Godziak out of Poland.
And he went down earlier with that just crazy Superman C-grab to late tail whip. Let's see if he can finish it out here and make it all the way to the bottom. Nice style. Opting not to go for that trick so far up top. Looks like he wanted to tuck the bars in for a no-hander, but doesn't quite get it. Nice, no-hander to tail whip. He's making up for it right now, though, Todd, as we move down into this extremely fast section. Yes, lots of style, and what's it gonna be on the final hit here? 360 tuck no-hander, and he gets a full pull.
Now the question is, was there enough sizzle from David Godziak to get him onto the podium? Remember, he's gonna need to throw down something special to take down Ryan Nyquist, who has the lead with an 89.6.
You know, you forget how big these jumps are. Just doing tricks like this tuck no-hander to a tail whip are impressive enough. Just getting down. I love the style here, a one-footed whip. And he brings it all back in to continue through this enormous rhythm section. Late tuck, 360. You know, this is a rider who spends a lot of time on the bike, even on the park courses, so we'll be seeing him a lot more.
His score, an 84.2, not enough to get him onto the podium. As we go to our next rider on the right of your screen, that is Kyle Baldock, currently in fifth, trying to get onto the aforementioned podium. Chris Doyle, standing next to him, is currently in fourth place.
Lots of control. This is definitely a similar approach that he did the last time. He just likes to stick to business up top. Oh, no way! That's a decade. One of my favorite tricks. Lots of linkage here off these jumps. Oh, this is huge. Tail whip backflip and throws a bar spin in there, making his way towards this shark fin. Pretty standard over it. What's he got for the first set? Yeah, off axis. 720 landing low, but will he carry the speed through? He makes it. What?
Oh.
No way! Kyle with a long dart front flip.
Big smile on the face of the Aussie, Kyle Baldock, with an amazing run.
Definitely decade air. I love that trick. It's one of my favorites. Really throws himself around the front end of the bike. And this, a bar spin at the end of this tail whip backflip. Really great. Judges are gonna love that. But how about, look at his head. He turns and looks at the crowd. What a cheeky guy. That's insane.
So he's looking to take an 89.6 or better, and he comes in with an 88. So Kyle Baldock does move onto the podium, and he's with Tina.
Well, and the crowd loved it, Kyle. That front flip, long dart. Just what is your reaction to that?
Oh, I'm just happy to pull it. I did it yesterday, but a little bit slower. But today, did it, give it a look to the crowd. They were killing it out there, you know?
And time was winding down. How satisfied are you with what you've been able to put down on this massive course?
Definitely, I'm satisfied, amazing. Just like everyone else, we go out there, we do the best we can every day. The crowd goes nuts for us, and we just go out there and do what we can.
You put on a show.
Thank you.
Yeah!
And it looks like the show's not gonna stop on the dirt jump. How about Kyle Baldock? Up close and personal with the fans here in Asheville that came out to watch. Next up, it'll be Chris Doyle out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, set to drop in here. This will be his fifth run of the competition here in the final.
He's got such a confidence when he rides his bike. I mean, this is a rider who doesn't deviate from what makes him feel good on the BMX bike, on these dirt courses. He actually told me years ago, you know what, Kenan, I don't like going upside down. I like to do what I do. And he's made an impressive career out of doing that. Look at how he just handles this course. 360, scrubbing some speed here. Lots of skill out of Doyle.
Chris Doyle, one of the tallest competitors here at Dreamline, as he makes his way now to the three final big hits.
You mentioned he's a tall guy. Not easy for some of the taller riders to make things look so good, but how about a Superman? Very buttery.
So the fifth run is complete for Chris Doyle out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, one of the older competitors, but one of the smoothest competitors on the circuit.
And you're about to see why. I mean, you know, up here in this top section, gets the 360, does a nice truck driver, brings it down, lands high on that landing, and he flows all the way through. No one does 360 turndowns better than Chris Doyle. And then when you just follow him through, that completely inverted tabletop, just stretching it out, buzzing the shoulder there. And how about it? Just drop the feet off the back end, no problem. Just gonna sail like Superman. He's even wearing a little bit of red. Looks like he's got a cape.
Good run for Chris Doyle, 85.2, and he's now standing by with Tina Dixon.
And when you think trail riding, you think Chris Doyle. Chris, how is this course and this jam format an example of just being out riding with your friends?
This is it, man. All these guys are my friends, having a great time. I grew up in North Carolina, so to have some North Carolinians here cheering for me and everything's really awesome.
How impressed were you with this course when you first saw it?
I was scared. I was nervous. But it's so good. Like, Adam Alois and Clint Reynolds and all those guys did, like, just a brilliant job putting it together. It's great.
Well, and it's so much fun to watch.
So good fifth run for Chris Doyle. What has he got left as he heads back up to the top of the course here at Dreamline? Ryan Nyquist is your leader, Kyle Baldock in second, and Pat Casey currently sits in third. This is 32-year-old Aussie Corey Bowen out of Brisbane, Australia, on course.
Corey has come to be known as a rider that's got a lot of style in the way that he executes his tricks. Look at this, 360s just look so good. Thing is, here you're gonna really need to lay down some big tricks with what we've seen earlier from some of the other riders.
He's chasing Ryan Nyquist, the current leader, with an 89.6.
Into the final rhythm section. Big nothing here on the first set, coming over that hip. And a tuck no hander. You know, in my opinion, this is not one of the runs that's gonna put him at the top of the podium. He is capable, but he just didn't throw down enough as we go back, and I'll take you through it. Corey Bowen, like I said, very stylish guy, but in this level of competition, you're gonna need to do a little bit more. This nothing, however, is completely stretched out. And he threads it together, throwing his back leg off, bit of what we used to call a Grizz Air, you know, or a Hannah. It's an old motocross trick. And then finally, a tuck no hander. Again, Corey, one of the best riders on dirt out there. Unfortunately, today, just not putting it together like he needs to.
And that score not going to get him onto the podium, so Corey Bowen checks in with an 83.2, his final run of the day. That takes us to our final run of the competition. This is James Foster, set to drop in. He's in fourth place right now with an 86.8. He would love to get on the podium. To do that, he's going to need to throw down an 87.2 or better.
Totally within his reach. See, I like what he's doing at the top here. If you notice, he's already five tricks in on this run. That's very cool. He also has a lot of style, so all the ingredients are there. Nice late tail whip. Very exciting there. See, he is throwing a trick off every obstacle on this course. Double tail whip.
This is it.
It looks like it was a triple tail whip. This rider is going off. That was an incredible run. Will it be enough to take Ryan Nyquist's lead? Back at the top, suicide no hander, and then he throws a tail whip in late. Lots of progression here we're seeing today in this course. X up on the way in from this tail whip backflip. And then finally, we got one, two, how about three times around? He is a weed whacker in the air when he does the triple tail whip.
Mark to beat an 89.6. Foster doesn't get that, but he does get an 89.2. So he is on the podium in second place. An impressive performance from James Foster out of Redlands, California. And he's standing by with Tina.
And you just keep doing new lines, but what is your assessment of that run? It looked so solid.
Felt really good. I did a trick up there that I've never done before, suicide to whip. Just having so much fun. These are honestly the best jumps I've ever ridden. Just kind of making it up as I go, but I'm having so much fun. I love it.
What was your first reaction when you saw this course?
I couldn't believe it. This is has to be the best dirt course ever built for a contest. It has to be.
And we've seen some great riding, including from you.
Congratulations to James Foster for his last-minute effort in getting on the podium. But the rider who stands atop the podium is Ryan Nyquist, and he gets our Red Bull signature moment. A four-time X Games gold medalist, Ryan dominated this course early on and left the rest of the field trying to catch up, leaving them to battle for second place after he laid down this run that included a variety of trick variations and huge airs. At 35, he is the veteran of this international field, but the man from Santa Cruz, California proved he still has what it takes and shows no signs of slowing down. Congratulations to Ryan Nyquist on capturing the Red Bull signature moment.
Ryan, you've been doing this a long time. So what does it mean for you to come out to the most progressive event with this kind of course and these riders pushing you and win?
It's an amazing feeling. That's all I'm going to say. I did not expect this one bit. Even when the contest was done, I was just happy that I came away unscathed. And then they were like, hey, we need you down below. I was like, wow, podium, that's pretty cool. Like, and then they were like, I don't know, just the names kept calling. And then they were like, you won. And I was like, I cannot believe this. I'm like speechless. I can't believe I did it. I'm happy, very happy, but I'm just speechless.
Well, when I talked to you guys earlier, you were talking about the size of the jumps and the size of this course. How important is it to have events like this in the BMX world?
It's very important, you know? Like, it's good to have the support from everybody that came out and just, you know, have events like venues like this where we're just able to showcase our talents. Like, it's super important. So, you know, cheers to everybody that put it on and made it a good show.
Well, and you guys put on a great show for the crowd. It was fun to watch. Congratulations.
Thank you. Loads of fun.
So here are the final standings. Ryan Nyquist gets the win. He's on the podium with James Foster and Kyle Baldock.
You know, I have to say, as an old guy myself, I love to see that Ryan Nyquist is still at the top of his game.
Well, that'll do it for us. Let's check in now with Sal Masekela.
Well, we promised amazing progression, and of course, we got it. Thank you for joining us and watching Dreamline from Asheville, North Carolina. Congratulations to Ryan Nyquist, still getting it done, and James Foster and Kyle Baldock rounding out the podium. Once again, thank you for hanging out with us, and we will see you next time.